يا استاذ.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يعني انا في الاول طبعا انا بقى انا محمود السلايد شيرد كده ولا ايه الاخبار؟
اي يا فندم، في شير يا فندم دلوقتي، بس فول
اوكي،
سكرين بقى ساعتها.
ما فول سكرين والله.
طب يبقى تمام كده يا استاذ.
تمام يا فندم،
اوكي
تمام
تمام تمام يا استاذ.
تمام. أنا طبعا في البدايه يعني سعيد جدا بتواجدي مع قسم جراحه العظام في طب بنها، واشكر الدعوه العزيزه من الاستاذ دكتور محمد الاشهب على دعوتي المشاركه في هذا الكورس المحترم، وجزيل التقدير والعرفان بتواجدي مع اثنين من عظماء جراحه العظام في مصر، هي واساتذتي انا شخصيا والدكتور خميس الدكتور اسامه حجازي. انا يعني ادين ليهم بكل التقدير والمحبة والتعليم العالي وكل مش عارف، يعني أشكرهم زي على منحهم الفرصة إن أنا أكون متواجد معاكم النهاردة يا دكتور خميس وحضرتك دكتور أسامة وقسم جراحة العظام في طب بنها، بشكرهم مرة تانية. طبعا لزمايلنا الأعزاء وإخواتنا، إحنا هنتكلم على حاجة من الكومن كونجينيتال لور لمب ديفورمتيز اللي هي الكلاب فوت. في انترودكشن سريعة كده على دايما بحطين لنا ايه هي الفانكشن اوف ذا فوت. يوجوالي ات جيفز ذا بيس فور سبورت اند ويت ديستريبيوشن، ات اكت از ريجيد ليفر تو بوش اوف، ات ابزوربز اند بيرميتس ذا فوت تو كونفورم تو تشينجينج ترين. ذيس از ذا فانكشن اوف ذا فوت اللي ربنا سبحانه وتعالى عملها لنا، وبالتالي اهم حاجه ان احنا دايما نوصل اي فوت ديفورميتي الى ان يكون اتليست plenty great functional food as much as we can, as we know ان الفابريكا ال 100% بتاعت ربنا سبحانه وتعالى. The most important joint الحقيقه في الكونجنتال كلاب فوت هو السبتيلر joint او the telocalcaneal articulation. هو it is not an isolated joint as we know from the anatomy, it is a part of the telocalcaneal navicular articulation. And usually its main function is conversion of the tibia rotation to the forefoot during supination and pronation. And this what happened during supination and pronation. During supination, we have three complex motions: adduction along the vertical axis of the leg, inversion along the longitudinal axis of the foot, and the plantar flexion along the coronal axis. And during pronation, the opposite will take place. Actually, we should know that the subtalar axis is directed from downward, upward, and medial. And لو قسنا الاكس ري انكلينيشن بتاعتها هنلاقي ان هي حوالي بتنكلاين اب زي في فيجر A حوالي 42 درجة، وهتنكلاين ميديالي 16 درجة بس. أكتر تندون ليه أهمية في حكاية الكلاب فوت هو تيبياليس بوستيريور تندون. وكنا زمان في الاناتومي واخدين ان هو inserted in all the tarsal bones except the talus. وبالتالي هو has a very important role for stabilization of the telonavicular joint during heel strike and give support strong to the medial longitudinal arch. And if dysfunction occur to it, it will result in what we called acquired flattening. This, as regard the very important anatomical relationship to the club foot, should be put in mind in addition to other anatomical landmarks. Also, you should put in mind that there is a developmental changes in the child at birth with growth. So if you see a baby at birth with normal foot, it is usually in slight dorsiflexion and eversion. It is normal. And active and passive plant dorsiflexion reach to up to 50 degree. And if accidentally, though not intentionally, do an x-ray for him, we will see the otic centers of calcaneus, talus, and cuboid. After growth 1 year, the sole will develop be flat, and this is due to the deposition of the fat and not due to actually the deformity of bulgus or flat feet. And the foot is everted and laterally rotated. What happened in the second year? The fat developed in the first year will disappear and will be replaced by arches, and the eversion and lateral rotation appearance will be less. The active and passive dorsiflexion of the frontal flexion reached to 50 degree and dorsiflexion reached to up to 30. And if you do an X-ray, we'll see the specific centers of calcaneus, talus, cuboid, and the cuneiforms. After that, after 3 years plus, plantar flexion, dorsiflexion, plantar flexion is stationary 50, dorsiflexion up to 25 to 30, and all the specific centers of the foot will appear, including, in addition, calcaneus, talus, cuboid, and cuneiform, secondary, the appearance of specific centers of the navicular bone. This is the commonest or the common foot deformities we may face with a baby, reach from club foot, metatarsus adductors, or ski foot, or vertical talus. But we concern today of only club foot, and we should put here only the metatarsus adductors, as it is one part of the deformity present in the club foot and should be differentiated from the club foot. It is common and considered as the most common foot deformity in child. Actually, it occurs in 50% of cases bilaterally. And don't forget, either in the metatarsus adductus or the club foot, you should examine the hips and you should evaluate all the baby for other associated congenital anomalies. X-rays not necessary to be done in such cases. The metatarsus adductus classified according this axis from the center of the heel, and if the foot is oriented vertically, the axis will pass in the second web space. According to its passage, third web space or beyond, it was classified accordingly into mild or moderate or severe case. What is the aim of classification of such a deformity? Number one, to do how to treat this case. Number two, to explain to the parent what is the prognosis of such a condition and what is the future of this deformity. And this is the shape of such a deformity, mild or moderate or severe, and maybe in severe cases, we do an X-ray to see the deviation of all metatarsal bone to the medial side. According to this classification, mild form may be resolved spontaneously or passive stretching exercise, and moderate may need serial stretching and serial casting, and severe cases need serial casting, and rarely it may be need surgical intervention. This is for the resistance, algorithm for treatment. Mild deformity will resolve. Serious stretching casting will be needed in moderate to severe cases till full correction, and then maintenance of this correction by nice plans and then medical shoes till specific age. But if the condition is neglected or recurrent or relapsed or received treatment and returned back, the age of the child was 2 to 4 years, it was advised to do tarsal metatarsal capsulotomy up to 4 years age, and bony operation only after the age of 4 years. Don't do bony operation up before age of four. This is the shape of dome-shaped osteotomy with at metatarsal basis at the bony correction of neglected or residual metatarsus adductus, through two incisions in the dorsum of the foot, and fully corrected and maintained ski wires removed after 2 months. Another operation is to elongate the medial side of the foot and shorten the lateral by wedge of the cuboid and insertion it in the wedge, open wedge of the navicular bone. Now we come to our title is the congenital club foot. Club foot is called talibus? Talibus is a Latin word called talibus. It is two parts. Tali is from the ankle and base of the foot, and combined it is a deformity of the foot and the ankle joint. Usually seen in age 1 per 1,000 live births, bilaterally in 50% of cases. The male instance is more common than in females, and positive family history present in 10 to 25% of cases. theory to develop such is it the bony problem and secondary soft tissue contracture take place or the opposite? But the primary germplasm defect is the main theory in the, which occurred in the talus. And this causes continued plantar flexion and the inversion of the talus. And secondary soft tissue changes and contracture take place. This one theory. But another one demonstrated that the primary problem is a soft tissue abnormality. And the second bony change will take place and result in this. Don't forget that the many, many diseases or syndromes associated with such a condition. So every patient with club foot presenting with, because it is the apparent, only apparent deformity, you should examine the baby for other associated congenital anomalies. What are the components of such a deformity? We have an equinus take place at the ankle joint, varus at the subtalar joint, adduction at the forefoot, supination at subtalar, and in severe cases, and this is the main principle of Ponseti manipulation, is the cavus with a depressed or plantar flexed ferrous metatarsal ray. And this is the shape of the cave or the cavus and adduction for foot, varus, and equines. The muscles contracted in such a deformity in the cavus are the muscles contracted and responsible for such a deformity as presented here is the tight in are the intrinsics, flexor hallucis longus, flexor digitorum longus. The muscles contracted during in adduction are tight tibialis posterior mainly. The varus is due to tight tendo Achilles, tibialis posterior and tibialis anterior. And the main component of the causing equinus deformity is the severe tightness and the malinsertion of the tendo Achilles. And this table demonstrating what are the strong muscles and not weak. Weak is not in the idiopathic type. It is imbalance between both the strong and weak muscles. What about the bony deformity take place in such a deformity? Actually, the talar neck is deviated medially and the plantarly and the plantar flexion. And the calcaneus goes into varus and deviated around the talus. Navicular and cuboid are displaced medially. The talocalcaneal joint is, in such cases, is severely tight. And if during correction, what are the elements or the pathological elements that prevent its realignment? They are the calcaneofibular ligament, the superior peroneal retinaculum, the peroneal tendon sheaths, and the posterior talocalcaneal ligament. And this to summarize and demonstrate that the elements of deformity presented on the medial side, on the posterior side, and on the lateral side, as shown in these figures. Many classifications are presented the types, and the simplest one is to call it is postural or positional one, but the more specific is to describe it either fixed or a rigid type. But in general, the flexible foot is the correctable one without surgery, and the distant one actually need surgical release. Ponseti 1963 put his classification system according to the ankle dorsiflexion movement and the deformity of heel varus, the degree of forefoot supination, and the associated association of the tibial torsion, and put this table to demonstrate the result of the treatment of his technique and not the clinical and not the condition of the baby at presentation. Accordingly, either result will be good or accepted, or it will give a poor result when, according to this ankle dorsiflexion degree, heel varus degree, adduction of the forefoot, and tibial torsion. Later on, Harold gives a more simple classification of such a deformity. and according to the degree of correction of the deformity by manipulation at his clinic, if the foot could heal at or beyond the neutral position, it is a grade one. If it is reached to up to fixed remaining equinus or plus or and or varus less than 20 degree, it is grade two. And if it is fixed with residual grade of equinus and or varus more than 20 degrees, it will be grade three. Pirani classification developed 1998, and according to this criteria, which will be depend on it on the clinical evaluation of such a condition, and we will see. And this criteria involving what we'll see in inspection, palpation, and movement of such foot. And accordingly, we advise to examine the child from the front, from the back, and from the medial side of the foot, he will demonstrate all these elements of deformity. So, we will see this foot, we should comment on the curvature of the lateral border of the foot associated with medial crease. As we know, there is no medial crease normally, but its appearance graduate for the severity of the adduction of the forefoot. Also, we should look from the behind to the presence of posterior crease, which is normally not present. And in equinus deformity, it will be apparent. Then shift to palpation. We palpate from the medial side, the gap between the medial malleolus and the navicular. We palpate on the lateral dorsolateral aspect of the foot for the tailor head. We palpate from the posterior for emptiness of the heel and the distance between the tendo achilles and the lateral malleolus. Then we move to movement for evaluation of the rigidity of the equine adduction and the long flexor contractures of the toe and big toe and other toes. And returning back to Birani, this what's happened, these all elements which we will examine during evaluation of the baby and put 1-0 or half or one scoring and to decide which type of the, which grade of the deformity is present. Now, when we was a residence, our professors told us that talibus is not an X-ray foot cases. We asked why we will not do an X-ray for a club foot. But reviewing the literature, it is very important, not for diagnosis. Club foot is a clinical diagnosis problem. But the X-ray is done to evaluate the progress of the treatment and if a complication takes place during or after treatment during follow-up. When it should, it is now, it is mandatory to do it during evaluation of each case, and it should be in non-ambulatory child, and the foot should be put in fully and maximally corrected position as much as we can to remove the soft tissue element for evaluation of the angles of the foot, which we'll see. What we'll see in the X-ray, we have three main lines, the talocalcaneal, sorry, three main axes, talocalcaneal axes in the anteroposterior view, and this demonstrating the degree of the varus or valgus here. The lateral talocalcaneal axis, it is done for the demonstration of the equinus deformity. And the axis between the talus and first metatarsal ray, that's for the evaluation of grade of adduction of the forefoot. Radiograph or X-ray findings are correlating well with the clinical appearance, as I said shortly, for the deformity associated. And this is an X-ray old before the تكنولوجي انستليشن اكس راي اون على الفانوس، وكنا بنرسمها بالقلم الفلوماستر والمسطره قبل ما تظهر بقى الخطوط اللي بتتعمل دلوقتي بالكمبيوتر واحنا قاعدين. Now we shift to very important title is the treatment of such a problem. The treatment consisted of manipulation, and we should know how frequently we do this manipulation technique, and after manipulation we maintain this correction by plaster of Paris or adhesive strapping or whatever, and after reaching to full correction of the foot we should maintain what we will reach by orthoses and medical shoes till specific age and time. This is the traditional technique. We are treating abduction of the forefoot, so we must put in abduction. We are treating equinus, we should correct by dorsiflexion. And we are treating the associated tibial torsion, we should be derotation. But serial manipulation described by Ponsetti give us the trend to be far away from surgical intervention. And I read many papers that described we can use Ponsetti technique in not presenting idiopathic or primary presenting club foot, but either in recurrent or relapsed conditions. And Ponsetti described his results up to 90% of success. He described two phases, treatment and maintenance, and this principle as to treat as early as possible. And you should treat the baby with very gentle manipulation and change of cast every week. And we should put in mind that the principle of correction according to the deformity elements, not all at the same time. You should correct first before the cavus with adduction and hilvaris, and after full correction, we shift to correction of the hind foot. This to avoid the correction from the abnormal location and the tarsal joint, which will result in iatrogenic complication, which is a rocker bottom deformity. Hicks described in 1950s. That's what we told the pronation twist. The foot is presenting in supination. So by logic, we should put the foot to do for her a pronation twist for correction. But pronation will increase the plantar flexion of the first metatarsal, which is already in plantar flexion. And this will result in more cavus deformity and more difficulty in correction of the deformity. So, must as we said, inversion or supination with cavus with adduction of the hind foot, because tarsal joint are all mechanically interdependent. This is the principle. We should put your thumb of the right foot on the head of the talus, and you catch the first or the foot, and increasing or correction of the adduction and varus of the foot in supination. First time to correct first the cavus and push the dorsal, the adducted foot toward the abduction. At the same time, we put the heel varus into valgus. This continued at least 4 times every week, according to Ponsetti, 5 casting maximum to give the period for correction of the adduction and varus of the heel. And this, the principle, you see in the up figures that the foot in the varus, cavus, and correct the adduction in supination to reach the foot cavus to normal position. During this, we correct the adduction of the forefoot and the heel varus. Why? Cavus, we know, is due to pronation of the forefoot in relation to the hind foot. This is what we know. So cavus to be require only supination to achieve normal longitudinal arch of the foot. So the four foot supinated to the extent that the plantar surface of the foot reveals normal appearing arch as we see in this figure. In manipulation consists of adduction forefoot, penis, the stabilized Taylor head. And we should locate the Taylor head biclinically before we start any manipulation. And we repeat again, we correct all the deformity elements except equinus simultaneously. Next, by adducting the foot in supination and hold it with gentle pressure 60 seconds and then release, the lateral motion of the navicular and of the calcaneus increase every time we correct this deformity, but don't forget, never pronate the foot. And this, after manipulation, he put his cotton and continuing the cast, as we see in this figure, he started from the below knee and then above knee, leaving part of the cast under the toes to prevent the contraction of the flexors, and remove part in the dorsum of the toes to give the baby the chance to do an active extension or full extension of the toes. And this is the steps of manipulations in application of the cotton and then completing the cast above the knee. And we note that the last figure downward right is the foot is in full supination. This is the shape of the cast after each visit. We know each cast show improvement, but adduction inverse, the first cast shows the correction of the caves. Second to fourth casting show correction of the adduction inverse. Then the remaining deformity is the equinus deformity. Either we continue manipulation and the correction of the equinus by manipulation. This one of the print, which is not wrong, but Ponsetti describes that we can do at outpatient clinic percutaneous tenotomy, did a complete cut of the tendon at its mid substance between the musculodynial junction and the insertion into the calcaneus. After that, he continued the cast for two to four times till full correction. But when to decide to do this tenotomy? When the anterior calcaneus can be abducted fully, because if you start to do correction of the equinus and the anterior calcaneus is not abducted fully, we will do crushing of the talus against the undersurface of the tibia. And this is very important. You must do full correction of the adduction and the varus of the heel to avoid crushing of the talus between the calcaneus and the tibia. Then we will maintain in the Dennis Brown or the orso ankle foot or so this present in marking according to your experience and your favorites. So the brace should be worn after full correction, full day, for first 3 months after last removal. Then the child wear is a brace for 12 hours at night, 2-4 hours in the middle of the day, means we reach up to 16 hours per day wearing the orthoses. And after walking, we shift the orthoses at night and the medical shoes during the day, and this will be instructed for the parents till the age of 4 years of age. But the child should be followed up regularly till the age of the school, which is about 6 years in our country. Sometimes after correction, the child walk with, during stride gait with, the foot is supinated and equinus. But at age 2-4 years, we may need for this procedure with tibialis anterior transfer to correct this supinated and equinus. So, what is the expectation of such line of treatments, whether surgical or conservative in clubfoot, and should be put in mind to describe to the parents? Because if the child has only unilateral foot deformity, you should describe to the parent that there will be difference in the length of the foot with growth, but the whole lower limb length, there is no discrepancy. Also, the circumference of the leg may be or may not, may be smaller than the normal size. Even in bilateral cases, this discrepancy may be present, but with different grades. And if the according to the degree of the deformity of the club, of the foot. When to do surgery for such a deformity? If the child do not respond to conservative treatment by serial manipulation and casting, this is logic. We must shift to surgical treatment. And surgery actually aimed for the conservative treatment, as I said before, to reach to the maximum functional plantigrade foot. This is the aim. Equinus, if residual equinus, we can do tendo Achilles lengthening, isotenotomy, or Z-plasty, or this is described techniques. And this is the open Z-plasty. And sometimes, if associated adduction and varus of the heel, we may shift to posterior release. When to do complete soft tissue release? If the feet is resistant and in young child, if during manipulation, as we said, and the foot is severely deformed, and an iatrogenic complication took place with you during manipulation, which is rocker bottom deformity, you should shift to complete release. If the club foot is associated with syndromes, if there is a delayed presentation of the child above 1 year with walking, we should shift to surgical treatment. The ideal age for complete soft tissue release is 9 to 10 months of age, because the child will be with fully weight bearing and walking. This is the principle, this is the dry procedure, the Turco procedure, as we know from posteromedial incision, and this is one of the procedures or technique used for complete soft tissue release, to release all elements of tissue soft tissue contracture described in pathology, and the reposition of the subtalar joint, mainly the talus and calcaneus, and restore the mechanical orientation of the talocalcaneal navicular joint. This is one technique through posteromedial incision. This is another one described by Carroll through 2 incisions, one on the medial side and one posterolateral. And Cincinnati, which is a severely extensive sensile approach, which could be done with the child brawn. These all are surgical techniques aimed for complete soft tissue release, to release all soft tissue contraction and the reposition of the bone to achieve the plantigrade foot correction. This is an x-ray before and after for the same baby. And this is another one treated conservatively with severe, moderate to severe club foot, treated plaster of Paris. And this is during follow-up. And this is the final picture of the foot. So what about the resistant types? If the child presented to you after the age of 5 years and presented only with the metatarsus adductus, here there is no rule for conservative treatment. We should do metatarsal osteotomies. But if below 4 years, don't do open bony operation. You must only capsulotomies and release of the capsule to correct the deformity. What about the hind foot varus? Either it is isolated or associated with other elements. At age less than 3 years, we do modified McKay procedure. But later on, the wire osteotomy or Darwin Evans, according to presence of the varus in either the isolated or as a part of the complex deformity of the foot. As regard the equinus, if the child is young, Achilles tendon lengthening and posterior capsulotomy is enough in mild to moderate cases, and the child is young. But in severe deformity and the older one and near to skeletal maturity, we should do Lambert-Nodi procedures. If all elements of deformity, adduction, varus, cavus, and forefoot supination are present, and the child has age more than 10 years, may be shifted to a complex or very ugly, I don't like it, procedure, which is triple arthrodesis, to achieve plantigrade functional foot, not correct cosmotic appearance. This is one of the procedures for adduction of the forefoot, either isolated or as part of the all club foot, with lengthening of the lateral column and shortening of the medial column and shortening of the lateral one by taking a cuboid bone grafting or wedge and put it in open wedge on the medial side to length the medial border of the foot. This indicated mainly in older children at age of 3 to 10 years. Triple arthrodesis preferred to be more than 10 years, and it is contraindicated in the foot without sensation, because it depends mainly for fusion on the proprioceptive impulses from the foot to the brain. Another procedure, surgical procedure, which could be advised is telectomy. And as we learned from our great professors before, telectomy is mainly indicated in not idiopathic club foot, but mainly in arthrogrybotic foot deformities. And actually, it is a salvage procedure and may be needed in arthrogryposis in younger age, but in age 8 to 10 years, without foot sensation, it may be help in correction of the deformity. Salvage procedure also with complex multiplanar club foot deformity is the multiplanar supramalar osteotomy, but it is not done isolated. It's done in associated with the foot deformity to correct the tibial torsion and not the club foot. So, as our great professor likes Lizarov, gradual correction by ring fixator is still a great option for treatment of severely and fixed deformed cases. And this is, for example, with a baby bilateral and one side of the right operated by the traditional post-remedial release and the other side treated by Lizarov with gradual correction. And this is the final before the first one, and this is the final. Don't forget that I think that the side treated surgically post-medial release, and my Lizarov orthopedic surgeons colleagues هزعلوا مني جدا ان انا قلت كده ان soft tissue والسكيلز بتاعه الريليز بتدي results better عن الرينج فيكسيتور. لانها محتاجه تريننج الحقيقه كيرف عالي ومحتاجه ناس اكسبرت، بس دي من اول الحالات اللي كنا عملناها عندنا في عين شمس، وانا هجيب لكم الفيديو بعديها بعد شويه لو في وقت بعد دكتور باذن الدكتور محمد، اوريكم ان الرجل اتعدلت بس بالتراديشنال تريتمنت لاينز از بيتر ذان ذا ليزارو. This is another example with complete soft tissue release. One of the complication or one of the most important items is the compliance of the parents. You should ask the parents to be regularly follow up for the baby, because if you do an operation like this, this is a very simple procedure done for this boy. He is treated conservatively and residual equinus and did tendo Achilles cleansing by Z-plasty and disappeared. He will return back to another one for tendo Achilles again, and this will result in infection and ugly scar in the posterior aspect of the ankle, and gives the surgeon very difficulty to correct this foot. So the compliance of the parents and the regular and the good relationship between the orthopedic surgeon and the parents to help this baby is a very important issue in treatment such deformity. Last procedures in tibialis anterior tear in this problem, it is indicated in, as I said before, in persistent varus and supination during walking. And actually, it is done at age between 3 and 5 years, and with indicated also if there is a poor compliance for brace management, and this not occurred if the relationship is very. This is a technique I will not go inside, but this is a principle with scar at 3 incisions, one on the side of a transfer, one of the attachment of the tendon, and the other side, we, as we see, this is, look to the figures, to taking the tibialis anterior into the third cuneiform. And sometimes you need an X-ray image and inspire to locate the lateral cuneiform to actually to be 100% transfer it to the very, this very small bone. Okay, this is the summarization of this technique. And this is my final presentation as regard the review of literature. If we have time, Professor Muhammad, I have only 10 minutes.
For of course, sir, we have time. Of course, sir, we will be great, sir.
Okay, sir. I will escape. And then screen sharing stopped, okay. And share screen, yes, okay. Now, sorry for, but this is a very difficult problem, as we know, for all the orthopedics and parents, but I will demonstrate not for nothing more than only one paper described the treatment of very resistant cases. But before, I should mention to my junior staff, what is the difference between different definitions of untreated treated cases? The untreated case is untreated cold cleft feet that not seek the medical advice from peers up to 2 years of age. The treated case is a treated cleft foot and receive treatment and reach it full correction. The recurrent cleft foot is the foot which reach or achieved good result with treatment, but the deformity is regained or returned back after full correction. A neglected case is the cleft foot in a child age more than 2 years with no or little treatment has been performed. Okay? The complex foot deformity is any foot deformity, not cleft foot only, associated with additional pathology or scarring, either from complication from treatment or surgical intervention. And the resistant one, which I will demonstrate now, is a cleft foot where treatment has been correctly performed, but the foot show no significant improvement. This is the resistant case of cleft feet. This is the paper I just mentioned now, is some problems for us, and I think he puts the solution. The treatment of neglected or relapsed cleft feet age 5 years plus is a challenging task, yes, of course, particularly in our developing countries. And most children can afford surgical procedures which are expensive, like in Elizarov. True. Next. And this is the excessive soft tissue release in such a condition. Both problems were in the skin approximation, in the wound healing, in the scarring post-operative, in the persistence of some element of deformity because we could not achieve full correction of the element of the deformity, and also this condition or treatment option need long hospital stay. These are limited resources for treatment of such condition. Also, he shifted to another bony procedure. The conventional one could not cause the foot fully. The triple arthrodesis associated with the stiffness and should not be done except after 10 years of age. Telectomy associated with high incidence of hind foot recurrence, pain, bony ankylosis in the tarsal joint. Wow. All procedures are difficult. All procedures are associated with complication. Also, the non-compliance for the subsequent casting had a high dropout rate. Also, casting tendo Achilles tenotomy was not sufficient. What he did? He did this osteotomy. This an osteotomy located at the apex of the deformity of the foot. And he put two transverse lines with the badge on the dorsum and the apex at the bottom. And he take the wedge as much as he can to achieve fully corrected foot. Where? In the cuboid bone and the 3-24. If it is not corrected, can he shift distally or proximally? Yes, he can shift up to the tarsal bones or shift to the talus to remove part of it to fully to achieve this foot correction. Look, this is a very resistant complex foot deformity, and this is the skin incision over the apex of the deformity, and he removed the wedge as we see in the figure, and then return as restoring as much as he can from to correct this deformity. Now, rapidly, this is some cases. This is a case with cavus, equinus, skin crease on the dorsolateral aspect of the foot, treated conservatively, and the equinus is very severe. After tendo Achilles, you can see in the lower figures that there is a scar of previous tendo Achilles. But this tendo Achilles with repeated manipulation could not achieve full correction of the equinus. This another problem in some severe equinus cases. You may see the foot in line with the leg. What we can do? But all elements are corrected and the child is too young. So I did step by step tendo Achilles procedure. I did tendo Achilles twice. One time to a maximum, and then next time to achieve the full correction, as we see. So this child may need, as in the total hip replacement for infected cases, you will have to do step one or step two عشان achievement اللي احنا شفناها تحت خالص ده. The another one, another example is this congenital severe foot deformity, as you see, and we did for her posterior media release. That's a good decision, wise decision, I think, yes. Another one, yes. Look for the foot during walking. You see the boy is coming with this figure and this walking. You look, what is our decision? Yes, we decide to do full correction by complete posterior media release, as we see. Okay, but this child, we did for the right side complete posterior media release, and on the left side we did Elizarov, as I mentioned before, and this is the final situation of the boy. This is before. Okay. You can see him, he is walking on the dorsum of the foot. And this after follow-up. I think on the left side with residual adduction of the forefoot is the case. Is the foot treated by Elizarov. Okay. Another example. This is simple by soft tissue release. Sorry for I take a longer time, but I need to finish. And this is another example. Show you the original Turku procedure. Give and achieve full correction of the foot. And this is the baby. she is starting to walk at this time. She's the first time to walk. Okay, this is the ugly scar with the previous operation. And they give me a challenge to do skin Z incision and take longer time, actually. And this is after full correction. Last one, this is an example of the tibialis anterior transfer. So, at the end, we summarize our notes that we must obtain or do our maximum to achieve the plantigrade functional foot at the time of treatment with surgical or conservative treatment. Finally, many thanks to Professor Muhammad Al-Ajhab and the faculty and of the organizing committee of this Banha seminar and course. Is very beneficial. I think well done, well organized. You did a lot of effort for achieving that. Inshallah, يبقى حاجة كويسة وصدقة جارية. وبشكركم تاني مرة لوجودي وسط أستاذ الدكتور خميس وأستاذ الدكتور أسامة. وأرجو إن أنا ما كنتش طولت وشكرا جزيلا لحضرتك.
شكرا جزيلا.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, our beloved professor, Professor Nabil Abdelmanan. Thank you. أستاذنا الدكتور أسامة موجود.
معاك يا دكتور.
Thank you so much. تفضل أستاذ. تفضل يا أستاذ.
طبعا الدكتور نبيل يعني من يعني البايونيرز في
التريتمنت
الحقيقه يعني بحييك ومحاضره جميله جدا وربنا يوفقك يا دكتور نبيل ان شاء الله دايما معانا كده ان شاء الله دايما
انا اتشرف انا اتشرف مع حضرتك ودكتور خميس دكتور محمد وزمايلنا اساتذه الاعضاء في كلها كل حته والله يعني ده شرف لينا وانا سعيد بتواجدي معاك حضرتك النهارده
احنا بنشكر حضرتك يا فندم على الاليجانت ليكتشر وكنا بنستاذن حضرتك نبدا الاسئله مع حضرتك
اتفضل بيه
هو بس اول سؤال في سؤال لحضرتك بالنسبه للميتاتارسس ادكتس هو لو عيان عنده من 4 لـ5 سنين في حد بيسال هو في تشانس فور ويكلي كاستنج
is there still any chance for weekly casting at age 4 5 years زي ما احنا اتفقنا we have درجات او grades of the deformity احنا هنريتيرن على فكره كله بقى بيرجع دلوقتي ايفن حتى في المايل كيسز irrespective to the age لو مايل كيس put him in cast it will correct okay بس بشرط ان ما يكونش حصل secondary bony changes okay لكن before 4 years اعمل tissue procedure زي ما انت عايز في المودريت تو سيفير كيسز اللي هي كابسولوتومي بوني بروسيدجرز ما فيش حل اكتر انك انت ما تعملهاش قبل سن 5 سنين بلس يبقى المايل كيس من درس الدكتس وقبل 4 سنين تراي انك تعمل مانيبيليشن وكاستنج مودريت وسيفير لا شيفت تو سيرج 4 سنين ماينس سوفت تيشو 4 سنين بلس بوني اوبريشن
تمام يا فندم هو اخونا دكتور اسماعيل بيسال حضرتك هو اولا بيوجه الشكر لحضرتك على المحاضره الرائعه وبيسال حضرتك هو كان عنده حاله سيفير كيفس وعمل لها بونسيتي وعمل لها تينوتومي واتحسنت والعيان كان عنده 2 سنين بس طبعا حصل ريلابس بعدها والسيفير كيفس فهو بيسال حضرتك ان هو يعمل بونسيتي تاني ولا يعمل بلانتر فاشيا ريليز هو العيان دلوقتي عنده 4 سنين
اوكي نمبر 1 هو اللي هو بقى بتاعه لازم هو كان يقول لنا هو عمل مينتنس للكوركشن بتاعه ولا لا يعني هو عمل
كوركشن هو كان حاطط العين في دينيس براون
دينيس براون فور 2 ييرز يبقى ماشي تمام طب ايه سبب الريكيرنس بتاع كيفس اذا كان الراجل عمل مانيبيليشن كويس وعمل مينتنس لدينيس براون ومفروض ان هو ماشي كومبلينت وماشي رجعت ليه يبقى وكمان ان العين ده ايديوباثيك يعني ما عندوش اي حاجه ثانيه ما خلي بالك الكارنت كيس دي يبقى ليها باثولوجي ثاني خالص يا سمود فاذا ما كانش هو ايديوباثيك ده فيري رير ان هي ترجع وخصوصا مع ان هو ماشي على الريجن بتاع تريتد مظبوط لكن لو رجعت يبقى لازم يسيرش فور اذر بوسيبيليتي او اسوشيتد باثولوجي موجود عمل هذا الكلام هنرجع لنفس الموضوع الايج بتاع 4 ييرز ده هل هو يكمل يس اديله ترايل على حسب الجريب بتاعتها ما جاتش استنى عليه شويه لان الكي بس از فيري ديفيكلت تو كوركت ايزو ده يعني بلانتر فاشيا ريليز اه طبعا ما فيش مشكله لكن يدي له ترايل ده الاجابه يدي له يس ترايل بعد ما يدور بعد زمان يا محمود
تمام يا فندم
سمين. بعد ما يدور اذا ما كانش في اسوشيتد باثولوجي سبب هذا الكيس
تمام يا فندم
اتفضل okay.
في سؤال لحضرتك من زميلنا دكتور عمرو بيسال French. حضرتك عن الفرنش مانيبيوليشن
اوكي طيب انا يعني كمان هستعين باساتذتي هو التكنيك بتاع الفرنش انا مش مذاكره لكن الفرنش اصلا الفرنساويين بيعملوا ايه على حسب معلوماتي هما ما بيعملوش مانيبيوليشن وكاستنج هما بيبعتوا موستلي اوف ذم لبتوع الفيزيو ثيرابي هما اللي يعملوا مانيبيوليشن وبعدين يعملوا ده مش فرنش تكنيك ده اي حد بتاع اطفال حتى بتاع بيدياتريك جنرال بيدياتريك مش اورثوبيديك بيدياتريك اورثوبيديك سيرجن هيبعت بتاع الفيزيو ثيرابي اعمل يا عم وانت مش هتشوف حاجه وبتاع الفيزيو ثيرابي ولا دارس ميكانكس ولا دارس فيسيولوجي واناتومي زيك عشان يقدر يعمل هذا الكلام صح يا دكتور خميس
انا معاك يا نبيل هو يعني هو طبعا الـ يعني الـ يعني هو زي ما حضرتك تفضلت الفرنش ميثود هي كده هنري بن ساهل كان بيبحث فعلا في العيانين وبعدين بعد كده يعني ما عندوش ثقه كتيره قوي في بونسيتي اعتقد كان في بينهم بعض كده سوء تفاهم يعني ولا ايه فما كانش بيحب المانيبيوليشن بتاعته وكانوا بيعالجوها بعد اذا كانش كده بقى يتصرف يعمل حاجات تانية بس انا نفسي اسال حضرتك سؤال اعتبارك يعني اندلجت جامد في التيركو بوسترو ميديا ريليس هتقول لنا حضرتك بتعمل البوسترو ميديا الانسيجن الظريف ده هل في اثناء الريليس دو يو ريليس ذا انتر اسيس تيلو كالكينيال ليجمنت ولا لا؟
شكرا بيه اولا شكرا حضرتك على الدوكيومنتيشن بتاعه الفرنش تكنيك دي وبونسيتي لكن في التيركو البروبلم في الباثولوجي بتاع الكلاب فوت ان البوسترولاترال ستراكشر بتبقى فيري تايت والانتر اوسيس تيلو كالكينيال ليجمنت بيبقى سام تايمز اوبستكل لان احنا نعمل ريبوزيشننج للتيلس على الكالكينيز فيو شود ريليز لو هي مش كوركت معاك علشان ما تبقاش ياتروجينيك كومبليكيشن دي نمبر 1 الحاجه الثانيه بقى اللي واحنا بنعملها لما بفتحها طبعا انا كده بفك البتاع ما فيش حاجه ماسكه في التيلس اصلا غير من فوق بقى الديب بارت بتاع الديلتويد ليجمنت وشويه بوستيرو تيلو تيبيال وشويه حاجات فيري فيري سمول فلازم حاجتين اولا هي بتديني ادفانتج ان انا اوصل لللاترال ستراكشر من هنا انا بعمل ريليز لللاترال سب تيلر وبوصل للشيز بتاع البيرونيل لدرجه ان انا طبعا محتاجه بقى يعني يعني مش هقول حرفانه لكن ان حضرتك ابقى واخد بالي وانا داخل ان انا بريليز التن لغايه ما اشوف الوايت ستراكشر بتاع البرونيوي وبعدين بعد ما بعمل ريبوزيشننج انا الشود دي من ضمن الانديكيشن اللي في اي ايه لازم تسبلمنت الريبوزيشننج بتاعك بتيلو كالكينيال كي واي فروم ذا هيل ما يعديش الانكل عشان هيعمل سلافنج في السكين يعور الابيفيزز الابيفيزيا جروس بليت فبعد ما اعمل ريبوزيشننج واعمل ريليز للانتر اوسيس تيلو كالكينيال لازم احط كي واير سبلمنتري لغايه ما اتشيف الفول كوركشن.
في ناس بتدعي انك انت لما تعمل ريليز للتيلو كالكينيال انتر اوسيس ليجمنت يو ار جوبردايزنج ذا بلاد سبلاي اوف ذا تيلس which is coming from the through this ligament to the tailus. ما راي حضرتك؟
لوجيك يا بيك بس ماكاي اللي هو اصلا ديسكرايبد هذا التكنيك وعمل يعني زي سكتش كده على العلب البوكسز وقعد يعمل بوزيشننج عملها وتعمل دراسات على الفاسكولاريتي بتاعه هذا الكلام ووجد ان نسبه حدوث الاياتروجينيك افاسكولار نيكروزيس اوف ذا تيلس نتيجه لجبردرايزنج اوف ذا بلاد سبلاي اوف ذا تيلس نوت مور ذان 10% لان بيحصل نمبر 1 في اذر سورسز اوف ذا بلاس سبلاي ليها نمبر 2 الحاجه سبحان الله زي الفيرسز بيحصل فيه باسترايزيشن وي دونت نو فروم وير
هو بس يعني انا عايز اطمنك يا دكتور نبيل بيه ان احنا في اسكندريه كان عندنا رساله كنت انا مشرف عليها، عملنا كنا بنعمل ريليس فعلا للتيليكوكين انتر اوسس ليجامنت في كل الحالات. وبعدين بعد كده كان within 3 months كنا بنعمل للعيانين دول ام ار اي، كنت انا بدفع نص التكلفه والكانديديت يدفع النص الثاني. None of these cases develop AVN of the talus. فيعني بنعملها وانت مستريح من غير ما تخاف ولا من غير حتى ما كان ما يقول.
لا ما هو لا ده انا بقول ايه على الليتريتشر بيه ان هو 10% لو حصل لهم. وعلى فكره ومش عارف هل هي من الريليز ولا من حاجه ثانيه من مانيبيوليشن.
يو ار رايت. انا اولا سعيد بمحاضرتك يا نبيل والله، ويعني مش عارف نفسي كده كل شهر ولا حاجه اقول انا محاضره وانت محاضره عشان اشوفك واسمعك يعني.
يا بيه ربنا يخليك يا رب يا دكتور كميز. انا اللي
ربنا يخليك يا نبيل،
انا اتعلمت من حضرتك يا بيه والله يعني.
كل
مش عايز اطول على الاودينس لكن يعني حضرتك استاذ الاساتذه
بارك الله فيك.
والله يا بيه ولن انسى فضل حضرتك علينا بيرسونال، حضرتك عارف.
بلاش بقى، طب بلاش بقى
سنة 2009 بيه عشان بس
ايه. بلاش بقى، بلاش بلاش يا نبيل بلاش.
والدكتور اسامة طبعا افضل على من اول 93 دكتور اسامة، بس عشان برضو الاودينس والناس تعرف ريليشن ما بين الاساتذة وان التايم فاكتور ده مهم، ان مهما بيعدي الزمن. انا تشرفت ان الدكتور اسامة سنة 93 ناقشني في رسالة ماجستيري، وان الدكتور خميس الديب 2009 كان واحد من المحكمين في البيبرز بتاع تاريخ الاستاذ بتاعي، وطبعا كان عضو لجنه الدكتور اسامه. ده تاريخ انا مش عارف الناس كلها بتسمعه ليه، بس لازم اقولها بيه، ده شرف ليا.
يا بيه كلك ذوق يعني، انت انسان محترم يعني.
ربنا يخليك يا بيه.
سي
دكتور محمود في اسئله اخرى؟
هو بس في زميلنا في الاخر بيسال هو ليه اساتذه مصر ما يتجمعوش ويعملوا الجوريزم اور سيرتيفايد بروتوكول فور ديبيتابل توبكس في البيرسز ديزيز. هو طبعا دكتور خميس عاملين بروتوكول في اسكندريه لمصر كلها يعني.
الدكتور خميس اقوى بروتوكول يعني. لا 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 العفو، لا العفو، لا بلاش تحيز، بلاش تحيز يا محمد يعني.
لا العفو يا فندم.
لا شوف يعني هو احنا بنعرضه ويعني يعني بنرحب باي نوع من التعديلات ونخليه باسم مصر كلها بقى يعني.
دكتور خميس بيه سعادتك يعني. سعادتك انا هفكر حضرتك بس لما كنا في الايبوس، لما كنا في ايطاليا وسعادتك بيرثس، حضرتك قمت من هنا كله سكت خلاص يعني. دكتور خميس دي الام خلاص. لا ده لا ابو ال العالم يعني. فلو تفتكر سعادتك لما كنا في ايطاليا مع بعض في
ممكن اقول تعليق صغير على الكومنت اللي قلته يا دكتور محمود بعد اذنك؟
اتفضل يا فندم.
برضو عشان حق الحق يذكر يعني، كان في من ضمن الاجتماعات زمان كده في اجتماعات مجموعه جراحه العظام الاطفال اللي هي تابعه لجمعيه جراحه العظام المصريه، كان فيها اساتذتنا طبعا ورحمه الله عليه الدكتور نبيه خليفه، وكنا الدكتور اسامه كان قال ان احنا عايزين نعمل زي حاجه، عارف انت البرشامه، حاجه كده زي الجوريزم للتريتمنت لكل حاجه يعني. جه سوبرا كوندايلا فراكشر هيومرس يتعمل، يتعمله بروتوكول للتريتمنت من اول عين يمشي، ويمشي يبقى ستاندردايزد على كل حاجه. انا اعتقد ان احنا ما شاء الله الاساتذه كتير والعلم كبير، لكن ربنا عدي الغمه دي بس والناس كلها تبقى تتجمع. واعتقد ان الكلام ده هو اللي هيبقى الفيوتشر، ان يبقى في دايما جايد لاينز لكل حاجه تتعمل. الجايد لاينز بتاعت اسكندريه دي ريفرنس، خلي بالك. والجايد لاينز طبعا يا بيه، والجايد لاينز دكتور اسامه في حاجات كتير، وجايد لاينز عندنا من شمس الناس اخرين، وجايد لاينز حضرتك دكتور محمد الاشب، وفي كتير قوي. لو جمعت كلها عايزه ايفورت كبير جدا، بس حد يبقى ليدر يجمع الناس.
تمام.